Hi, my name is Jean. I'm a program manager from Microsoft Windows Container Team focused on AKS HCI. In today's presentation, I'd like to focus on AD authentication for modernize your Windows application. As you know, Windows container cannot be domain joined, but a lot of applications still need AD authentication. What can you do? Group Managed Service Account, gMSA, can help. The second challenge is leveraging gMSA in Kubernetes is not an easy process. We just announced AKS HCI GA. AKS HCI is an on-premise implementation of AKS, Azure Kubernetes Service. One of the highlights in AKS HCI for Windows Custom is they no longer need to domain join Windows worker node. I have two demos today. One is how to modernize your Windows application using gMSA on a standalone server. The second demo is how easy you can leverage built-in gMSA support to modernize your Windows application in AKS HCI. Before we jump to the demo, first let's talk about service account. So in Windows, there are multiple types of service account. Service account is a user account, basically. You can treat it as a regular user account, but there's no password you need to remember. Service account is created to run a particular service or software. It needs to be individually managed. And also like password rolling and SPN. So in large network, management of this service account can become very difficult. So this is where managed service account come to picture. Managed service account can provide automatically password management, but it's a one-to-one mapping between the service account itself and the computer. So the service account cannot be shared across computers. So in Windows Server 2012, grouped managed service account was introduced. And it can be associated with multiple computers. That means a group that has a member of exactly the computer which allowed to retrieve the password of the gMSA, which provide a lot of flexibility. In the first demo, I will show you how to modernize .NET two-tier application with gMSA in Windows Container. This application is a typical ASP.NET MVC application with SQL as a backend. SQL Server is using Windows authentication. The first thing we want to do is to go to the domain controller to create a gMSA account. Domain controller. Here's my domain controller. You can see, use this command line to create the gMSA account and grant certain machine account to be able to retrieve this gMSA's password. You can also view the properties for this gMSA account and see who has the permission to retrieve the password. Here is my application. You do need to change a single line of the code. And here's the connection string is connect to my SQL backend. And also the library is my database name here. So you can use Visual Studio built-in tool to push this, to build and push the container image to container registry, or you can use other ways you are familiar with to push the image. Here I was using the built-in tool. You can also use the WAC tooling. Container extension to push the image. It's very convenient tooling. And also you can even write your own Docker file. Next step, on a standalone domain joined Windows server, have the Docker installed, download container image of the app. Then the next step is to create a credential spec. Here's the credential spec. This file contains metadata about the gMSA, and it will be passed to the Docker engine to run this container. This credential spec will be reused by AKS HCI gMSA solution in my next demo. The next one, we are going to create and run the container. So look at the parameter I'm using and the credential spec. Okay, the container is running. So that means my application is running. Let's open the browser and see if it works or not. Oh, my website is up and running. Then let's click the list of the books. The list of the books will retrieve the data from the SQL backend. I can delete a record here. I can also go to my SQL backend to validate if the login was using the gMSA account. Okay, looks like my gMSA login is successfully proceeded. The timestamp and the program name are all correct. Okay, let's talk about Windows container in Kubernetes. Kubernetes started supporting gMSA with domain joined host last year. Same as the demo we showed previously, the container uses host identity to retrieve gMSA password from AD. Because we use host identity, that brings the requirements for domain joined host. That way it works. When we attempt to create a container, we use credential spec and said we need gMSA and host goes to retrieve the password. This is not an issue if we only run on a single server. But if you are using Kubernetes solution with multiple Windows worker node, trying to scale up the Windows node, upgrade the node, or introduce a new one, it causes a lot of churns. In general, domain join is a heavy operation. To config gMSA end-to-end is not an easy process, and it includes quite a long manual steps. To address this, in new model in AKS HCI, we are using non-domain joined host solution for gMSA. We are connecting the node to secret store. The store is to store the domain user account. That identity has permission to retrieve gMSA password. When you request the container to request gMSA, the host goes to the secret store to retrieve the user identity, then that to the AD to get the gMSA password. We also introduce a couple of PowerShell commandlets to simplify end-to-end process to config gMSA. In this demo, I will show you how easy AKS HCI can deploy Windows application with gMSA using non-domain joined host solution. Here, we have a AKS HCI target cluster ready with at least one Windows worker node. To deploy gMSA, the first step is to install webhook. Okay, we can use this commandlet to install the webhook. Webhook is successfully running. Next, add secret with AD user credential to the cluster. The AD user credential is the one has access to retrieve gMSA password. Here's a YAML file for demonstration purpose. Let's go ahead to apply the secret YAML file. Next, let's add credential spec. Now we are ready to create a gMSA credential spec to cluster. File here was the one we created in previous demo. This JSON file, along with the secret object name, was just created get passed to add AKS HCI gMSA credential spec commandlet. After credential spec is installed, we are ready for application deployment. Here's the YAML file for deployment. This application is the same one as the one in my previous demo. Notice the name of the credential spec resource is referenced under secret context with the secret created earlier. Let's deploy the application. Now we can see the application and service are running. Let's go to the application homepage and to do more validation. Same as last demo, we can retrieve the list of the books, which is from the SQL backend. We can add a new book. To validate even further, you can log into the SQL backend and see gMSA login record reference in the credential spec. Okay. That's all for the demo. If you have any questions on AKS, HCI, or Windows Container, feel free to drop a line in our GitHub and we'll get back to you as soon as possible. Thanks for watching.